Milk solid not fat prediction using artificial intelligence and digital image processing. Abstract: the supply chain of how milk is collected and processed is complicated. First, it starts with milk societies where farmers gather to sell their milk for a price. When the milk is given to the societies, a sample of milk is taken for testing of milk fat percentages, solid not fat values, and the water content. Based on one of these values, the price is fixed. However, there are quite a few issues when the employees collect data. An issue is high costs of production. With the setup costs of data collecting machinery and balance scales, the cost will be significantly higher. Hence, there was an idea of creating a novel digital method of predicting milk SNF values, mainly through capturing it by a snap of an image from one's phone. The way to predict the milk SNF was through using the RGB values of the image, and then using models such as linear regression, support vector regression and artificial neural networks. By collecting primary data and feeding it through the models, it was found that a linear regression model was best suited, with an overall mean absolute error of 0.12, and a mean squared error of 0.2. Keywords: artificial neural network, N, mean squared error, MSE, mean absolute error, MA, RGB, solid not fat, SNF. I introduction. India is the largest producer of milk on earth. India, as of 2018 to 2019, has produced over 187,749 tons of milk and contributes to about 5.3% of India's GDP as of 2019. When the supply chain of the dairy farming industry in India is analyzed, it could be seen that the main source of milk comes from small farmers, about 90%. Then, the milk is collected at designated centers called milk cooperative societies. The price per liter of milk a farmer is paid is determined by the solid not fat value, the fat percentage and the water content of the milk itself. There are various methods used to test this, ranging from manual to chemical methods. This work tries to make a novel method of predicting some of the properties of milk, by using machine learning. The idea was to use images of milk samples, split it into RGB values, and then use machine learning models such as artificial neural networks, support vector regression, or linear regression to predict the milk properties through a given value of the red, blue, or green pixel intensity. 2. Existing system. Although there is a plethora of methods available to predict milk fat and SNF, there are two main methods that farmers use in order to predict the respective yield. One is the ASE2, accelerated solvent extraction, method, and the other is the Mojanya method 1, and they have their own disadvantages. A. Disadvantages. The accelerated solvent extraction, ASE, method takes place in a high temperature and pressure environment in order to extract the desired material, which in this case is the milk fat residue 2. However, this could not be achieved in a rural setting too, as one cannot have easy access to chemicals or a laboratory in a village. The Mojanya method uses organic solvents to extract fat of a milk sample, which will then be measured in a flask, and subsequently, the fat per liter will be determined 1. Since this process requires the use of organic solvents and manpower to evaporate and extract dry fat, the costs required to determine the milk fat are high, especially in a rural setting. Furthermore, it is estimated that the Mojanya method takes 2 to 3 hours to completely determine the milk fat yield. 3. Methodology. A formulation of data set. Primary data was collected in a local village called Kadayampati, with over 100 samples of milk images taken, the actual SNF and fat percentage values taken into account. B. Image pixel intensity extraction. After data collection, the average RGB pixel value was taken for each of the photos using the Python library OpenCV. Then, in a .csv file, the red, blue and green pixel values were uploaded separately, including its respective measured fat percentage and the solid not fat value. Then, using the Python library pandas, data were being analyzed and the correlation was found using the chi-square goodness of fit test. It was found that the blue pixel value of the image of a milk sample had the greatest correlation with the SNF value of that respective milk sample. Therefore, the only two variables that were taken into account for the prediction were the solid not fat value and the average blue pixel value. See Artificial Neural Network and its ARCA T-Coder. Artificial neural networks, ANNs, have become very popular in using it to predict linear and nonlinear relationships. An ANN has weights and biases, to which it timely updates after each iteration as the dataset of information is fed through. With its optimization functions, the ANN effectively updates its weights and biases to predict the input data. An artificial neural network has nodes, from which there can be different neural net architectures. The architecture of the neural network intended for this research is shown above. There are about 150 input neuron/nodes wherein the multidimensional RGB pixel value array is fed forward. Then, there are 6 different hidden layers in the middle, shown together in diagram, that have 100, 85, 70, 25, 20, and 20 nodes respectively. Finally, there is a singular output node that gives a computed fat value in a 1D array. D using support vector regression. Support vector regression is a supervised learning model which works similarly to support vector machines. A support vector machine, SVM, is used for classification, where it analyzes data points, creates boundaries, and a line of best fit given the existing parameters. But the key difference is, in support vector regression, the line of best fit is used to predict continuous data, whereas in an SVM it is only used as a decision boundary to classify data into two types. E using linear regression. Linear regression is a statistical tool used to effectively model the correlation between two different variables 3. In this case, the independent variable is the blue pixel value, and the solid not fat value as the dependent variable. After plotting a regression line, one could extrapolate and interpolate solid not fat values with an input of the value of the blue pixel. 4. Hyperparameter optimization. A artificial neural network. Learning rate. The learning rate is one of the parameters used in an ANN, wherein it controls how quickly the model adapts to predicting the given data. Choosing the learning rate is a trade-off between accuracy and time. A larger learning rate will be faster but less accurate predictions and vice versa. The other parameters were kept constant, with epochs equals 200, batch size equals 256, activation function is softmax, optimizer is atom. Different learning rates were tested on the validation dataset, and as shown below, it seems that any learning rate from 1 to 0.1 seems to give the lowest mean absolute error. Table I. Learning rate and MEI. Batch size. The batch size is a number which indicates the number of samples to go through during each epoch or iteration to update the weights of the neural network. In order to find which batch size fits the model best, different batch sizes were tested using the validation dataset, with other parameters being constant, epochs equals 200, learning rate equals 0.1, activation function is softmax, atom optimizer. The batch size of 75 and 100 performed the best, with MEI equals 0.56. Epochs, the number of epochs is the number of iterations a model goes through. During each epoch, the model is fed through the training dataset each time and internal weights are updated accordingly. In order to find which number of epochs fits the model best, different epochs were tested using the validation dataset, with other parameters being constant, batch size equals 20, learning rate equals 0.1, activation function is softmax, and has an atom optimizer. It could be seen that it performed the best when there were 50 epochs, with MEI equals 0.5733. The reason higher epochs did not work were because the model might have overfit the training dataset, that it performs in a worse accuracy during the validation dataset. Choosing optimizer. Optimizers are algorithms used to change attributes such as weights and biases in order to achieve the lowest possible loss, or error. To find which optimizer fits the model best, different optimizers were trained and tested, with other parameters being constant, batch size equals 20, learning rate equals 0.1, activation function is softmax, 50 epochs. It could be seen that an SGD, stochastic gradient descent, optimizer performed the best, with MAE equals 0.56. B. Support vector regression. Kernel, kernels are functions that process the given input data to an SVR model. The types of kernels that could be used in the scikit-learn library are linear, poly, RBF, radial basis function, sigmoid and precomputed. All these parameters, with the exception of precomputed as it does not fit the dimension of the matrix, will be tested in order to see which gives the lowest mean squared error. The parameter which does not change throughout changing kernels is the regularization parameter C and another parameter called gamma. As shown in the table, the kernel linear had the lowest mean squared error while poly had the highest. Therefore, the linear kernel was chosen as the parameter for the final tuning of the support vector regression model. C. Regularization parameter, an SVR tries to optimize the function, where it tries to maximize the number of points that are correctly classified in the training set. However, it is highly likely that the model might overfit. Overfitting occurs when the model gains a high training accuracy in the training data set, but fails to predict poorly on the validation set or whenever new data is fed through. The C parameter for, here, focuses on the extent to which the model could be overfit. A small parameter of C increases the length of the decision boundaries, while a larger parameter of C encourages a smaller margin. In order to find what value of C suits the model the best, trial and error needs to be taken place, with the mean squared error of the validation data, a completely unseen dataset apart from the training dataset, taken into account. Furthermore, it is important to keep the other parameters constant in order to ensure that C is the only factor/variable affecting the obtained MSE value. Hence, the kernel was fixed to linear for all the tested trials, and the gamma was fixed to 0.1 as well. Analyzing the trend of the mean squared error with respect to an increase in the value of C, it could be seen that, generally, from C equals 0.001 to C equals 10, the MSE is approximately 1.8, and then as C increases, the value of the MSE increases from 3.61 to 5442.26. The value of C as 10 performed the best, to conclude, because it had garnered the least mean squared error of all. V. Analysis and discussion. Metrics used, MSE, MAE, R2. MSE, or mean squared error, has the following formula. Where Y is the actual value, Y is the predicted value, N is the number of data points. Mean absolute error is another metric, wherein the absolute value of the difference of the observed and predicted value is taken, instead of squaring it. This could be expressed by the following. Again, Y is the observed value, Y is the predicted value of the statistical model, and N is the number of data points. Lastly, there is R2, which is the coefficient of determination 7, where SRAES is the residual sum of squares and STO is the total sum of squares. R2 shows the extent to which there is correlation between the two variables. A linear regression. Here is the table of metrics and the graph obtained by using the linear regression model. B. Support vector regression. From the hyperparameter tuning section of this paper, the parameters selected are C equals 10, kernel equals linear. And now, to look at the. Here's how the final model of SVR is, with parameters tuned for a high degree of accuracy. See artificial neural network. After choosing the parameters in which the mean absolute error of the validation dataset is the lowest, 50 epochs, 75 batch size, 0.01 learning rate, an SGD optimizer, the MSE and the MAE was found to be 0.4891 and 0.5602 respectively. 6. Conclusion. To conclude, if there exists a need to make a digitized system to predict the solid not fat value, different from the traditional methodologies, one could opt for the linear regression method, then using an artificial neural network, or a support vector regression model, as it obtained relatively lower MAE-MSE and higher R2 values. Acknowledgement. The author would like to thank Drivi.Mariapan.B.V.SC, Assistant Director of Animal Husbandry Veterinary Hospital at Perundurai, Erode, Tamil Nadu, India for his guidance throughout the project work.